T-budding is a grafting technique that should be in every grafter's arsenal. It produces very good results when grafting peaches, plums, apricots, and many other types of fruit trees. The technique requires the use of young branches of the same year for scions, and each graft uses a single dormant bud located in the axil of a leaf petiole. The bark should be sleeping for this technique to work, so it can be used in the spring, summer, or even in the fall, before the cold nights start to render the rootstock dormant. The traditional method of T-budding cuts the bark of the rootstock horizontally and vertically, making a T-shape. A single bud from the scion is then inserted inside the bark and stays protected under the bark flaps. The bud can be removed from the scion with a thin layer of wood or simply peeled off from it. Both options work fine, although the later one can be a bit more difficult and dangerous to your fingers. A variant of this T-budding technique cuts an inverted T in the rootstock bark. This approach gives better results under most conditions, and it can be a bit easier to execute. When pushing the chip down in the traditional T-budding, it's easier to damage the bud. If the bud is damaged during insertion or when it's being protected, the graft will fail. Pushing the chip up at the base of the petiole, it's easier and there is little chance of damaging the bud. Protecting the graft in the inverted variant is also easier, since there is more space to apply the tape above the bud. Also, in traditional T-budding, the flaps are open at the top and the graft is much more exposed. If rainwater makes its way inside the graft protection, the cambium tissues will not fuse together and the graft might fail. With the inverted T-cut, the larger opening is at the bottom, so gravity helps to prevent rainwater damage, even if the graft protection is not fully watertight. I usually use a couple of different models of the Victorinox Falco line of budding knives, but many other brands are also available, and they will do the job provided they are correctly sharpened. Check the video on sharpening grafting knives in the channel to know more. Smaller budding knives are recommended for debudding, as the buds are often quite small and delicate to be handled correctly by larger grafting knives. Also, since these budding knives have a single edge cutting blade, they make removing the buds while cutting at the same depth much easier. I particularly like the 39110 model, since it has a brass bark lifter at the end of the knife, which helps opening the bark flaps in tougher rootstocks. For younger rootstocks and scions, the models with a bark lifter in the opposite side of the blade are usually better, since they are thinner, so they don't damage the more delicate bark when opening the slot. The bud can be removed with or without a small piece of wood. When removing the bud with a thin layer of wood, don't use the same type of lower angled cut commonly used in cheap budding. The angled cut will be more difficult to adjust at the base of the inverted T-cut. Use a straight cut at the base, since it will align better with the horizontal cut in the bark. The graft should be covered when it's healing to protect it from dehydration. If the buds are too fragile, you can leave them uncovered, or the tape might damage them if you apply too much pressure. Nevertheless, covering the bud and sometimes even the petiole will help in preventing dehydration, and it will give the graft more protection until it heals. If you can't find parafilm, you can simply use plastic strips cut from plastic bags to tie and protect the graft. However, these plastic strips will have to be removed after 4 weeks. That's usually the time most grafts will take to heal. If the plastic strip stays in place, the bud won't be able to break it to start growing, so the graft will fail. When using parafilm, there is no need to remove it, since the bud can break this wax-based tape easily, unless you cover it with several layers. So, covering the bud with a single layer of stretched parafilm is the recommended procedure. Remove all the buds and small branches below the graft. After 2 weeks, if the petiole falls off when touched, the graft has taken. Leave a few small branches with leaves above the graft until it heals to promote sap flow. Remove them gradually after the graft starts to grow. If the graft starts growing vigorously, it's a good idea to support it to avoid breakage. The following year, the graft union will be strong enough to support the new branch. Check the channel for other videos on T-budding, chip budding, and other grafting techniques. If you appreciate my work, like, subscribe, share the video, and leave a comment to help me make more. Click the bell and turn on notifications on your device so you don't miss my next videos. Thanks for watching.